Hi, I'm Rohit Mirza. I'm from Mumbai. I play as a winger for Gokulam Kerala FC. So I started playing football when I was 12 or 13 for my school, and I really loved playing football. So we, all of us together, we made a team in our locality, and we'd go to every corner in Mumbai. We'd play football, and we love playing, and we play for cash prizes, we play tournaments, we'd win, and we got better and better, and eventually we heard of this team holding a tryout for a professional team, an academy. It was called Mumbai FC, and all of us just took it as another opportunity to play together on a regular basis, and we went in for trials, and then we got in, and I was what, 14, 15 at that time. All of us were around the same age, and yeah, so we started playing for Mumbai FC. Me, on the other hand, I didn't have a lot of that from my family, because my family is a conservative Indian middle class family, and they wanted me to become an engineer. Yeah, while I was in the academy, I was studying to be an engineer, and I was still playing for the academy. I played the under 19 I-League with my team. One of the coaches that was at Mumbai FC, he had a lot of faith in me. He saw my potential. He asked me to stick with football. He offered me a professional contract. There were really long days where I'd get up at 6 and go to the gym with the team, and then end up in college at 8 for 8 hours, then go back on the ground at 5, and that's where my day ended. And these were 3-4 years of this. And 4 years down the line, when I was in my last year of engineering college, I got my first I-League match. It was a long wait, and was a really long process, and I did well in that match. I made an assist, and we won the match, and so that was the last match of the league. Next year, I was one of the probables to start the matches, and I got a lot more matches in the next year in the I-League, and eventually I took the eyes of certain ISL scouts, and then I was in the Mumbai City ISL team in the draft, and that was a very big experience. I got to play with Nicholas Anelka. That's a big name in world football. I doubt a lot of people don't know him. Then there was Manuel Friedrich, who played for Dortmund that year. And then there was Freddy Ljungberg, the Arsenal star. I got to learn a lot from them and the coach at Mumbai City FC. And then there were a few more years at Mumbai FC. That's how I started playing football. So a year or more ago, I had an injury that was pretty big for me. I'm pretty big in football. It's known to end careers. It's, if not the biggest injury, it's one of the biggest injuries. And yeah, it happened in an East Bengal match, and it was against one of my former coaches. There was a lot of anger there, and I guess that's the reason, all the anger, it just came out at one point, because I never do these kinds of things, and I suffered the consequence for it. It was a rash challenge, and then I got hurt, the other person got hurt. But I suffered the worst side of it. And after the match, I'm sitting in an hospital bed, and I'm telling my family this, and it's weird, because you can't convey these things to your family, because you can't process that it's happened. So you're in a totally different state of mind. You can't talk to people, and my x-ray was out before my family could see it, and there were social media posts sent by my friend saying that, you know, like, Rohit Mirza suffered a career ending injury. You see that with a plaster on your leg, and you don't think that you're gonna, you know, that you don't think of playing with that much pain. And it was more of a task to come back to Mumbai, where my operation was supposed to be done, from Kolkata. and this club helped. Gokulam Kerala FC helped me a lot, and I got back to Mumbai and they took care of the operation, and that wasn't easy either. When you get operated, and anyone who's had an operation would tell you that they wake you up just to check whether everything's okay, and in that moment you feel nothing but pain. Like, and especially when there's a rod inside your leg and your whole leg is screaming. So then that was, so you don't, at that point after the operation, I, with that much pain, I thought that I don't want to play football again. It wasn't that I can't or can, it was I don't want to play that because of the pain. And then days passed and my family stuck it out with me, and a week or two of not moving from the bed, you're using a walker and you're walking on one leg with a walker, and you just it was still, and the pain didn't reduce. It was there for a month, it went on for 2 months, you're using a walker for 2 months and you're not getting out of the house. And at that point, I just wanted to walk, I wanted to run with my dog. That's all I thought about. That was my aim. That my aim wasn't making it back on the pitch. My aim, at that point, I set up a small goal. I just want to be able to run. And I worked towards it every day. Every day, there was a physio coming in. I would go to the physio, someone would drive me, and that's hard for me because I never liked taking someone's help to do things, and I couldn't do anything without someone's help. That was the condition I was in. So then eventually every day, adding those small bits of, you know, the physio helping me out, forcing me in the pool, forcing me in the gym, and me forcing myself in the gym every day, getting my motions back together, the movements that are necessary to walk. You have to relearn everything. You have to relearn walking, you have to relearn running, you have to relearn passing a ball. And it was almost 6 months of that after I started walking. From the second month to the 8th month, I had to relearn how to play football. I used to mark the days of my return to the pitch, and it was around, what, 6 months until I started playing again and I had a limp. And eventually I worked a lot physically in the gym with the physio, with a trainer, with a conditioning coach, and all of it. Eventually in 2 months, with a lot of work, I was able to play again. Not at the same level I was at when I got injured, but I was able to play again. And that, even that doesn't cut it. It doesn't cut it because when you're playing, there's a fear in your head that your leg had broken. You have to overcome that every day you step on the field. And that's how I did it. It's a challenge, but I think that that's the only way that you step on the field, even if you're afraid. And then eventually it wasn't there. I came back, I spoke to the owners of Gokulam FC, I spoke to the coach, and they wanted me back. They told me that after the operation itself, they told me when I got hurt, they said that you're going to be here. And I'm very grateful to this club for that. I'm very grateful to the owners and the coaches that called me back. And they called me back for a medical test, and I cleared that. I played a lot of practice matches. And then finally, after a long wait on the stands, after seeing the team play from the sidelines, just working on myself alone probably, or with a couple of other players, I finally broke into the team. And then I got my first match against Indian Arrows, and it was a big step for me because it was the first match after 12 months. Yeah, so you're afraid when you're stepping onto the field. It was like I was going to play my first professional match ever. It was like that kind of nervousness. And I think there was a big weight that was lifted off my shoulders when I played, when I completed that match. And I think it's because of the coach, and I'm very grateful. Even though the result wasn't in our favor, but I was grateful and I was happy that I played the match. I guess I've always been this way. I've always worked hard because that's the only way I got to play football, even when I started playing. Like, it didn't come easy. I had to push through a lot of barriers to even play football, and I love playing football. And after a big injury, when you think that you might not get to play football again, it was just the beginning, because after a couple of weeks, I knew that I was going to play. And when you get to that point where you think that everything is a blessing, even a training session, even any sort of things, like it's then you don't take it lightly, because you can't let it slip. Like, every day you have to work hard and do your best. The results might or might not come, but I think that you have to do your best. It's what you owe to yourself. That's what I believe. So I've been in Gokulam Kerala FC for 2 years now, and this is my second year. And I've grown fond of this club, not only because of the football, and because of everything, because of the owners, the coaches, the fans, and the way this club is. And I think I've played in a couple of clubs, and it's a very professional club, and it takes care of the players. And that's nice about this club. And I'm always grateful because they gave me an opportunity to play again. So I am. There's nothing but gratitude for this club. And when it comes to the fans, you hardly find it in India that 30,000 people come up to see an I-League match. This used to be in Kolkata or for derbies or whatever. But here they come out in numbers every match, and that's fabulous. That's awesome. So there's a lot of football fans in the city, and even when they recognize you that you're from, you play for Gokulam, and it's a nice thing to have. For a football player, everyone should experience that. I'm from Mumbai, and I think that this city is very much quieter and it's more peaceful than Mumbai. The hustle bustle is less. And I like it this way. I've grown used to this. Yeah, so the plan was to play for the country, and then, you know, that's how I started playing football. And I think that hasn't changed, and I still want to play for the country. So I would try my best, and I would try to get as many matches and do as well as I can to eventually play for it or not. It's in God's hands. And that's one of my ambitions. And then when I'm done with football, I think I would want to be related to football. I would want to be a coach or open an academy or, whatever's written.